Rubicon looks just like what we've come to expect an ATV to look like. Functionality first, but with just enough flash to make us look back at it when we're walking away. In climbing on the Rubicon, we can see exactly how Honda has written a book on ergonomics. The first thing you notice is the big, easy-to-read digital gauge pod that displays the ATV's speed, along with an hour meter, a clock, an odometer, dual trip odometers. Certainly, all that information is not necessary, but it sure is nice. Also, readily at hand is the key and the pull knob that operates the choke. On the left of the pod is a rotating control that, when twisted, switches the unique transmission of the Rubicon from one of two different automatic modes to a programmed shift mode that operates much like a standard shift ATV. And it's this feature that really sets the Rubicon apart from any of the competition. And it's more than just unique. It is perhaps the best of both worlds. Riding where you'd prefer to control the gear ratio? Well, put the Rubicon in ESP mode and it will shift the electro-hydraulic transmission into one of five preset positions. But never has any standard shift ATV shifted so smoothly. In the Rubicon's case, shifting the gear shift button doesn't actually shift any gears at all, but sets a hydraulic transmission to a preset position in the infinitely variable ratios. Now, if you prefer to leave the shifting to the Rubicon, you still have two choices. One programmed for more torque, and the other for more RPM. Whatever you choose, you won't find a smoother operating transmission anywhere. A first ride almost seems as though the Rubicon is electric. The shifter for the transmission is located on the left side of the tank and has reverse in the far back position, with neutral, one step forward, then high range, and low range to the complete front of the pattern. With the transmission control knob set in ESP, the shifter must be moved to either high or low range, and then the gear selection is by a pair of rocker buttons located on the left handlebar. Although the Rubicon starts in gear with a brake applied, evidently the folks at Honda don't consider reverse a gear, as the starter will crank away, but the engine will never fire. Go figure. Although we couldn't get any official word from Honda, it seems as though they've been listening to the complaints about the Rubicon being too stiffly sprung, as the newest model got everyone's attention with not only a smoother and more compliant ride, but seemingly better shock valving as well. And while you won't mistake the ride for a sportsman, the Rubicon certainly will be a surprise to the big and slow crowd. And out on the trail, the Rubicon handles well under almost all conditions, but two factors keep it from being really great. There is no two-wheel drive mode, and there is no lock-up. What this means is that with any tire choice other than stock, you'll be fighting the steering, as the front differential remains always engaging and always hunting for traction. And in the process, it pulls the ATV from side to side each time it finds it. But that never seems to be a problem if you're content to leave the stock tires on. Around the farm or work, the Rubicon does what's required easily and without complaint. It starts easily in gear, forward only, and goes from forward to reverse with a push on the shifter's button and a pull back. The engine is smooth running and the transmission engages at a low RPM, allowing the Rubicon to travel slowly, very quietly, and with very little vibration. And although the shocks remain non-adjustable, they continue to provide enough rising rate in the springing to not only work well under lightly loaded trail conditions, but also under the heavy, extra loads around the ranch or farm as well. The Rubicon provides a well-rounded package, perhaps slightly aimed more towards work than spirited trail riding, but thanks to wonderful ergonomics, a great handling chassis, and an incredible transmission, does well in every situation. The good? One-of-a-kind transmission, standard-setting ergonomics, and proven reliability. The bad? Not the most powerful, lacks both two-wheel drive and a locker, and doesn't start in reverse. The bottom line? An ATV that is both unique and reliable and works hard and plays well.